Hi everyone, welcome back to another video of Let's Custom. Today we're here at Shabba Max. Today's actually the registration for Slam at the Lake. I'm not entirely sure I'm going to enter as yet, because I'll do some future explaining to you guys, but I think I might still enter. So if I don't make the deadline, but if I do make the deadline, I will be there at Slam at the Lake. But I'm just waiting for Shabba real quick. I don't just want to walk into his place, so I'm just going to contact him on my phone, and then yeah, I'll show you guys around what the wheels are here and what cars are here as well. I would like to interrupt today's video to thank today's video sponsor, Charles Rensburg. Charles sells multiple Honda accessories such as a headlight washer kit for the Honda EK, number plate extensions for the front bumper, and custom dealership number plate brackets. If you would like to give your Honda a turkey spec look, buying these items and fitting it on your car is definitely the way to go. Once again, thanks to Charles Rensburg for sponsoring this video. Let's get back to it. We recently arrived home and these wheels look amazing. We managed to get four tires worth of wheels. Obviously we bought all four tires second hand, so big shout out to Wheel Up for actually selling us one tire, because we were only in need of one tire to complete the set. So if you guys, even the selling was either, definitely contact Wheel Up. I'll leave all the information is down below if you guys are interested in buying second hand or brand new tires, or even want to exchange or removing foot tires or even fix punches. I'll leave everything in the description down below. But let's just take a moment to appreciate how amazing these aftermarket VTEC wheels look like. If you guys didn't know this, aftermarket VTEC wheels actually looks exactly the same like original VTEC wheels. Look how nice and shiny this looks. I can actually tell from experience, it's actually way better to buy a brand new set of VTEC wheels than buying a second hand original set, because you're obviously going to spend a little bit more money to repair that set. But now you have a freshly painted set right here. We bought the set from Shabba, and the only difference between the Shabba set and the Racing Edge set is the center caps. But obviously I do have a connection with center caps. If you guys even in need of center caps, I know someone that 3D prints VTEC center caps for 150. He sells it for 150 a cap. I'll leave his number in the description down below as well if you guys are interested, because we might change this caps real soon. I'm gonna put you guys on a time lapse for the installation of these wheels on the car, because at the current moment Tegan has the 16-inch spoons on. The main focus will be to get the VTEC wheels on the car, get the car nice and clean, and we can go for nice cinematics with this car as well. So I hope you guys enjoy it. And by the way, I did enter for Slam at the Lake, so I'm entering for Slam at the Lake just in case. Just in case I actually finish the other thing. But if I don't finish the other thing, then unfortunately I'm just losing my entry fee. It makes sense like that. So I think I could still attend the event, but it all depends if I will be attending the event with the other thing or not. So comment down below. I would appreciate all the help I can get with this car, because I would really like to get the car, or get this specific car, to Slam at the Lake on the 3rd of July. I'm not entirely sure if you guys seen this, but I made my own rams. This is such a perfect design. So I made two, and I made it like this at the back. So if you guys would like your car to actually go on a higher height, you could do another separate well, step up from here, like planking here, plank till here, and then obviously another step up. But I think that's actually sufficient funds, because if you make it higher than this, unfortunately it won't fit in underneath your side skirt. So, yeah, Tegan?
Tina.
Shot! We have this one right here as well, so are you gonna use it in front, Tegan, or like on one side first? You first gonna put the front on, or are you gonna put like front and back on?
Front, back. Huh?
Side. Okay, we're gonna do it side for side, so. Okay, we're gonna do that side first. Alright, so what we do, the key to making this, well, thing right here is to get the distance between, well, this till there, the same as the other one, so, because you're gonna drive with the same motion on it, so you guys will see shortly. If Tegan actually drives on them, he actually gets to the, well, the second plank, the exact same time as he gets to the second plank at the back, so, yeah. Check out right there. Go. Aha, Tegan, what's going on, man? Go. Go. Azay. Ah, are you reverse? Clutch control, buddy, clutch control. Clutch control. Aha.
No. No.
Alright, guys, I just take two. Tegan, grab over the whole thing, Eugenie. Take two. Alright, Tegan, reverse. There we go, 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 go. Azay. See? Works like a bum. He's just Tegan it. Hele ding om. Hele ding verkeerd omgerij. But guys can see that there. It's basically at the exact same location as the one in front. Don't do what Tegan just did. He's a dicer. He wanna dice. Guys, guess who made a turn here by us? Doesn't the car look familiar? Doesn't this car look familiar to any of you guys out there? If the car does look familiar, definitely comment down below. You guys probably will remember that thing there on the door. So if you guys do remember the car, definitely comment down below. There's the owner standing. There's the owner standing. That will be all for today's video, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you guys did, don't forget to smash that like button. Definitely comment down below if you guys do remember that on the blog in the video. I apologize for the video being a little bit too short, but this week has been a little hectic. I've been busy these past few weeks, and if you guys obviously well took note of the video, guys know that I actually ended for Slammed at the Lake. It's not to say that I will be there. It's just that I entered just in case I get the other thing done and I can actually attend the event. So I would really appreciate everyone's support well, towards the other thing to get it done. There is a few life changes that might come soon because as you guys know, I did study and I'm busy with well, kind of working with my internship and kind of deciding if I actually should well, go that route or should actually like take the YouTube channel even further. So comment down below what you guys think of that. But other than that, I think that will be it for today's video. There are definitely exciting content coming up. It's just the time and space to actually record it and get the ball rolling. I know I promise you guys tons of content, and I promise you guys tons of content regarding the yellow thing as well. I would just like to mention as well that the merch is in the process of getting printed and getting like finalized. So if you guys did order the merch, I really apologize for the delay. RaceBlitz is actually working with all the orders. So once I actually get all the orders, I will actually pack everything up, get each one's order sorted, and then I'll actually get it ready for collection or ready to be sent out if you guys did pay the additional delivery fee. I appreciate each and everyone's support out there. Once again, I apologize for the short video, but there will be long videos coming up. And do comment down below what video length you guys prefer. 10 minutes, 15 minutes, 20 minutes, 30 minutes? Do comment down below. I'll see you guys in the next one.